Welcome. My name is Tom Bonifield. I am a high voltage isolation technologist at Texas Instruments, and we are in one of the high voltage labs at TI. This video is part of a video series on quality and reliability of high voltage reinforced isolation. This video will focus on the reliability of the working voltage of the reinforced isolation. Reinforced isolation is realized at TI by using thick silicon dioxide capacitors combined in series, as you can see in the upper left schematic cross-section. In that schematic cross-section, there is a die on the left and a die on the right. Both of them have high voltage capacitors and they're connected in series. Each channel uses high voltage isolation capacitors on both die. The combined isolation capacitor thickness is greater than 21 microns. The result is very high isolation voltage ratings, 12.8 kV surge, 8 kV peak transient overvoltage, and 1.5 kV RMS working voltage. In this video, we're going to talk about the reliability of the working voltage. The main isolation electrical lifetime test is time-dependent dielectric breakdown, or TDDB. TDDB is a standard methodology for determining the lifetime of a dielectric as a function of voltage. TDDB is an accelerated lifetime test, and as you can see in the graph on the left, the voltages for the test are the blue dots, and those voltages are at 5,000, 6,000, and 7,000 volts RMS, which is much higher than the working voltage of 1,500 volts RMS. At each of the test voltages, Weibull statistics are used on a population. The population of units meets the certification requirements of IEC and VDE, which require greater than 96 units from more than three lots. The Weibull statistics at each voltage enable us to measure the average lifetime, which is called T63, or 63% of the units have failed, and the point in the lifetime when the units are still less than 1 ppm fail rate. That less than 1 ppm fail rate is the dashed line in the graph on the left. The multiple voltage data is then fit to a model. The model is a standard model for TDDB, where the time to failure is exponentially dependent on the applied electric field, or in this case, on the applied voltage. Because it's exponentially dependent, as you can see in the graph, the lifetime on the y-axis is on a log scale, and it spans a very long range from 10 seconds at the bottom of the graph to 300 years at the top of the graph. The way to use this data is to compare the 1 ppm line to the isolation rating. You can see that comparison in the upper left of the graph. There's three different ways to compare the margin of the actual data relative to the working voltage. One is the voltage margin. So if you look at that line for 40 years, then if you follow it over to the right, you can see that the 1 ppm line has more than 1 kilovolt RMS margin relative to the isolation rating of 1.5 kV. Another way to look at it is the lifetime margin. If you look at the line for 1500 volts RMS, you can see that the 1 ppm line is far exceeds the 40 years. In fact, it goes above the top of the graph, meaning it's more than 300 years. Another way to look at it is the failure rate. T63 is where the failures occur. 1 ppm is where 1 ppm of the failures would begin to occur. And you can see that the data is much below 1 ppm. In addition to the working voltage, this data, it can also be used to assess the margin above the isolation rating itself, VIOTM. VIOTM or VISO are rated to have 60 seconds is required at the rated voltage. And so you can see the symbol on the curve for VIOTM at 60 seconds at 5.7 kVRMS. Now, looking up from there, you can see that the actual data is several orders of magnitude above the requirement for VIOTM isolation. This requirement for TDDB data is now part of VDE 0884-11 standard, and this is the first technology to certify to that standard. We chose silicon dioxide for our dielectric because of this really outstanding reliability. In this table, you can see a comparison of dielectrics that are sometimes used in isolation products. First is air. Air has only 1 volt RMS per micron, so that requires the 8 millimeter creepage and clearance to protect against air breakdown. Epoxies are much better at 20 volts per micron. Silica-filled mold compounds, as we use in our package, are, again, much better. They're at 100 volts RMS per micron. Among polymers that are used in some kinds of isolation products, polyimide is one of the best performing polymers for isolation. And you can see that there, that polyimide has 300 volts RMS per micron breakdown strength for a ramp to breakdown test. And silicon dioxide is even higher than that, at greater than 500 volts RMS per micron. But in addition to the breakdown strength in a test like a ramp to breakdown test or surge test, silicon dioxide is also outstanding in its dielectric strength over 40 years of continuous stress. You can see that for silicon dioxide, even after 40 years of continuous stress, it can be rated at over 100 volts RMS per micron. But polyimide is much lower. The reason for that is that moisture absorbs into polyimide, which degrades its lifetime under continuous operation. These are the reasons why we chose silicon dioxide for our isolation barrier material. In addition to TDDB, we test using the isolation standard tests of Method B1 and Method A. The Method B1 and Method A tests consist of two parts. The first part is an isolation test, a high voltage test to screen out units with defective capacitors. The second part of the test is a partial discharge test. In the partial discharge test, we follow the same 5 picocoulomb test standard that is required for all isolation technologies. In the case of Method A, the qualification test, the isolation stress is at VIOTM voltage for 60 seconds. And the partial discharge test is at 1.6 times VIORM, or 60% above the working voltage for 10 seconds. Method A is required by external standards, IEC and VDE, and it's required to verify VIOTM on a sample basis, requiring a quarterly monitor. Method B1 is also used in qualifications, but it is also required as a production test. For Method B1, the isolation stress is at 20% above VIOTM for 1 second, and the partial discharge test is at 1.875 times VIORM for 1 second. External standards, IEC and VDE, require that all reinforced isolation units must be tested in production. In conclusion, TI's reinforced isolation family of products has high voltage capability that exceeds the requirements for reinforced isolation. The quality of the high voltage isolation is demonstrated by substantial margins using statistical test method. And the reliability of the high voltage isolation technology is proven by time-dependent dielectric breakdown, which is the industry standard method of proving lifetime at use conditions. For more details, you can go to ti.com/isolation to find the white paper, Enabling High Voltage Signal Isolation Quality and Reliability. Thank you.